So you want to know how to change your brakes on your 2006 to 2015 Chevy Impala? Well, you came to the right place. Stay tuned. All right, so these are the tools you're going to need to change your brakes. You're going to need the jack, your C-clamp, your 3/4 inch socket, your breaker bar, and your 13 millimeter right here. Those are all the tools you need.
Because you wanted to know how to change the brakes, 2007 Chevy Impala. First thing you got to do, you got to pop the hood. Next thing you got to do is you got to remove the brake fluid cap. It's an important first step.
All right, next step, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to loosen the lug nuts. So right now we've got a 3/4 inch socket with the breaker bar for added support. So what you want to do, also make sure you want to loosen this thing in a star pattern. So we're going to start here. And then the star pattern, you're going to want to go here. Right. Now that they're all loosened, we're going to jack the car up, take the tire off. All right. Now when you're jacking up the car, you want to make sure you use the spots that they provide. You'll be able to find that because there's a guide in here, because the jack that comes with the car has a V-slot, and there'll be a beam that you'll put the V-slot into. We got the Super Duty floor jack, so we don't have that issue. So right here, with this kind of jack, you just want to make sure you have your 4 points of contact, so each one of the wheels are located on the ground when we say 4 points of contact.
Next step, taking the tire off. So we got these things pretty loose.
So breaker bar makes it nice and easy. So again, we want to stay in the star pattern. All right, set the tire aside and get to the business. All right, there's a 13 millimeter bolt here and here on the bottom that you've got to take off completely to remove the caliper. God bless. Got a little rust action in here. How you like that, Michael Hearn?
So when you remove the caliper, you don't want this to hang because you don't want your brake line to snap. So make sure you rest it somewhere. I mean, anywhere here is fine as long as you've got a nice spot so that brake line doesn't snap.
And now these are your brake pads, and these just pop right off. Boom. Boom. All right. Now there's a special tool you can buy to push the pistons back, but a nice 100 millimeter C clamp will get the job done just fine. So right here, we're going to take the old brake pad, put it up against here. So you're going to want to twist this until the pistons are completely flat, and then we'll go to the next step.
Okay.
Now, we've got the pistons moved back, and now the reason why we take off the brake fluid cap is so that when we squeeze the pistons back, we don't get the pressure built up, so that'll just shoot the pistons right back out, because that brake fluid's got to go somewhere when we push it back up. So that's just a way to alleviate that pressure.
There you go. And we'll just put on the brake pad like so.
Boom. Slides right in. The back one goes in the same way. All right, now that the brake pads are in, next thing we're going to do, we're just going to put the caliper back on. So your calipers, gotta push these back, and your caliper slides right in. Just putting the bolts back in. So we're gonna hand tighten top,
Same thing on the bottom. Screw that in. And we'll hand tighten here. So got our 13 millimeter here. And so the next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna regular tighten this thing here and boom, we're in. Brakes have been changed. Just gonna put the tire back on, let the car down. And again, you're gonna wanna tighten these in a star pattern just like you took them off. Just for balance. All right, now you just gotta put the cap back on. Boom.
Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna pump the brakes. So, we're gonna get in the car.
Start her up. And so what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna push it all the way to the floor. Let it come back. All the way to the floor. Let it come back. All the way to the floor. Let it come back.
You wanna keep doing that until you can feel it stiffen up.
So you don't want it to just push easily back. You want it to
have a little rigor.
Change your brakes as easy as that. You go to a shop, they might try and charge you $300 for the front and $300 for the back. For $25, $27 with tax, bought my two front brakes, was able to change that. The backs are a little cheaper because they're slightly smaller, but the process is exactly the same for all four tires. So, for $50, it's all it'll cost you to change your brakes and a little hard work.
All right.
Last thing you want to do, you want to take your car for a test drive through the neighborhood real slow. You want to make sure your brakes are fully functional and they're working fully operational. So if they're not working right after you do all this, there's something else wrong with your brakes and you might want to go see a professional. 614 Life, you're welcome. All right, next step, what you're going to do is you're going to loosen up the lug nuts. And then what you're going to want to make sure you do is you want to do this in a star pattern. So if we start here,
you're tightening it.
Oh God. Take two.